Malia White made history as the first female bosun on the Below Deck franchise. She hadn't worked on yachts prior to boarding the Sirocco as a deckhand for season 2 of Below Deck Mediterranean, but she used the time since then to work her way up in the intensely competitive industry. According to an interview with Vulture, it was leading lady Captain Sandy Yawn who inspired Malia to follow her dreams. And now, as she returns to the Below Deck fold aboard season 5's Wellington, the bosun feels like she's exactly where she should be. Speaking about her aquatic ambitions, she said, "I've always been drawn to work on the water, and I think, after that first season, I was like, okay, this is a career change, and I'm just going to go for it. I haven't looked back since." Her comeback sparked major discussions within the franchise's fandom, which is par for the course for any repeat star on the popular show. Malia was eager to return to Below Deck Med for two main reasons: to work under Captain Sandy again and to show off everything she's learned in the intervening years.
Malia, my favorite bosun.
Hey, Captain Sandy.
Welcome to Spain.
Welcome to the vow.
As Malia explained to Vulture, "Ever since season 2, I've continued my career. I've gotten my 200-ton captain's license and I've been an engineer. I've constantly stayed on yachts as deckhand and then worked my way up to bosun. Then I also got my paddy scuba instructor certificate so I can teach scuba diving. It's been a long road, but Malia is passionate about a career on the water. She's already proven her chops as a rescue diver too, jumping into the ocean to assist a guest in difficulty during a season 5 episode.
Malia is such a badass. She's f***ing awesome.
Her drama with Chef Adam Glick, with whom she previously had had a brief and rocky relationship, is far behind her too. Malia is now happily settled down with Chef Tom Checkitz, who is also the new chef on Below Deck Med. Although she's looking to put past issues behind her, Malia came under fire for making a lengthy pronouncement on Instagram after castmate Hannah Ferrier was caught with Valium on the boat. In a since-deleted Instagram post, Malia defended her actions on an episode of the show during which it was implied she told on Ferrier. She argued in the post, "Reporting any incident, especially one we witness, is all of our job. Yachting is my career. I'm not here to worry about plot twists and TV drama. I'm here to do my job and learn how to become a captain." While some fans believe Malia is in cahoots with Captain Sandy to get Ferrier kicked off the yacht, Malia insists that things are great between the three women. Speaking to Vulture, she said, "In a way, I felt even more confident because I know Hannah, I know Captain Sandy, so I expected the level of support I would get. I was very excited to have us three come together and show people that women can have these leadership roles and they can do it together." Fans who watched Malia on season 2 of Below Deck Med will remember that she ended up falling for bosun Wes Walton. The pair dated for a while after the charter season ended, but the relationship ultimately did not work out. While the romance wasn't meant to be, at least Malia got a good friendship out of it. She told Bravo's Daily Dish in early 2020 that she and Wes still keep in touch. She shared, "He has had some amazing yachting experiences recently. He's been traveling all over the world. We're still good friends. He keeps me updated with his travels and I tell him about mine." Wes apparently even gets along with Malia's current boyfriend Tom Checkitz. As Malia recalled, "Him and my boyfriend actually hung out in New Zealand, but I wasn't there, which is funny. Small world, yachting is." Malia may have broken ground as the Below Deck franchise's first female bosun, but the journey hasn't always been an easy one for her. As she told Refinery29, from her perspective, misogyny remains rampant in the yachting industry. As she puts it, "Everyone comes from such different backgrounds culturally, so there's a huge learning curve on boats anyways, and then you mix up genders and different gender roles and leadership roles, and it gets even more interesting." The impact she's made as Below Deck's first female bosun isn't lost on her, and she hopes that it's part of a bigger change. She said, "I think it's something that people are ready to see, and I think that it's a good representation of where the industry is going because a lot more females are starting to step up everywhere, hopefully."
Girl can hope.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite reality TV stars are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.